Now a NewsHour essay. Chef Jacques Pépin arrived in the United States from France in 1959. He's the author of the widely cited French culinary textbook, La Technique, the star of several PBS cooking shows, including one with his friend and fellow cook, the late Julia Child. Tonight, Pépin shares his idea on the essence of a recipe.
For someone who writes recipes, there's a paradox between the written recipe and the creation of a taste. When writing a recipe, one records a moment in time which can never be duplicated exactly again. The paradox is that the recipe tells the reader, this must be done this way, when in fact, to get the result you're looking for, the recipe has to be modified each time. The exact reproduction of a taste, which is what the making of a dish is, only works when the processes, timing, and ingredients are adjusted and changed to fit each particular situation. There is a gap between the step-by-step procedure and the completed dish, just as an artist cannot equate the technical process of painting with the finished work of art. Several years ago, I wrote a recipe for pear in caramel sauce. The idea was you peel the pear, cut them in half, remove the seeds, sprinkle them with sugar and place them in a very hot oven. Exposed to the heat, the juice of the pear seeps out, combined with the sugar and create a caramel. By then, the pear are cooked. Add cream to the caramel and the resulting sauce is poured around the pear in a serving dish. As the sauce cools and thickens, it is finished with a bit of pear brandy or cognac. When I first created this recipe, the pear were done in 30 minutes. That amount of time only reflects the unique set of circumstances I faced, ripeness of the pear, type of roasting pan I used. This is what happened on that particular day. The next time, I used pear that were more ripe, and they were done in 10 minutes, but the liquid around had not yet turned into a caramel. So I removed the pear, reduced the liquid to a caramel, and finished it with cream. The third time, I used bosc pear that were very hard. No juice came out of the pear and the sugar started burning. So I had to add water to the pan to create a caramel. The pear needed almost an hour of cooking, even though my recipe said 30 minutes. Yet, at the end, the three dishes looked and tasted the same. If the recipe had been followed to the letter, the finished dish would have been a disaster. But understanding the idea in the Platonic sense behind the dish enabled the cook to adjust and compensate for ingredient, temperature, humidity, etc. So what is the point of a recipe? A recipe is a teaching tool, a guide, a point of departure. You have to follow it exactly the first time you make the dish. But as you make it again and again, you will change it, you will massage it to find your own taste, your own sense of aesthetic. I've had dinner many times at the home of friends who cook from one of my cookbooks, and I've often been amazed at how far away the dish has moved from the original recipe. But it is not necessarily a negative experience. In fact, it is sometimes better than the original. And I end up getting credit and thanks for a dish that has nothing to do with me anymore.